Hachette Audio presents Created for Connection, the Hold Me Tight Guide for Christian Couples, 7 Conversations for a Lifetime of Love, written by Dr. Sue Johnson with Kenny Sanderfer, read by Sarah Mollo-Christensen. This program contains a Mac and PC compatible PDF.
Dance me to your beauty with a burning violin. Dance me through the panic till I'm gathered safely in. Lift me like an olive branch and be my homeward dove. Dance me to the end of love. Leonard Cohen. I can see now, God, that your decisions are right. Oh, love me, and right now, hold me tight, just the way you promised. Now comfort me so I can live, really live. Your revelation is the tune I dance to. Psalm 119, verse 75 through 77, The Message. Introduction by Sue Johnson. This is an exciting time for anyone aspiring to understand and begin deliberately shaping their most important love relationship. The first best-selling version of this book laid out the revolutionary new science of adult love and the couple therapy model, emotionally focused therapy, EFT, based on this science. It also described the explicit map to lasting love that this science now offers us. The book was designed to reach a broad general readership. However, a trusted Christian colleague of mine, Kenny Sanderfer, recently asked me to consider writing a version of this book specifically for Christian couples. His rationale was compelling. Christians seeking guidance for their love relationships want to know not only that what they are reading is grounded in sound research, but also that this guidance is completely consistent with their faith and the scriptures that guide them in their pursuit of divine wisdom. This made perfect sense. As Kenny and I placed the science of EFT alongside the ancient wisdom of the Christian scriptures, clear and consistent parallels between EFT and biblical teachings about divine love and God's teachings about human love leapt out at us. It is not surprising that a system of understanding love relationships based on the best of modern research on adult love is so consonant with the wisdom of this ancient book of faith, which is bookended with images of marriage, Genesis chapter 2 and Revelations chapter 22, and emphasizes the centrality of love from beginning to end. Science and spiritual wisdom often teach us to see things that, once we are aware of them, seem obvious and mirror our own innate sense of truth. The main reason for the revision of the original book, which is titled Hold Me Tight, is the passion that both Kenny and I share for helping couples, all couples. Kenny communicated to me that, as a Christian, his deep calling in life is to help couples of faith find the love they were created to experience, with God and with each other. I agreed that it would be difficult to find an institution more committed to the task of reconciliation and the restoration of loving relationships than the church. Kenny pointed out that, unfortunately, divorce statistics show just how much people of faith struggle in their marriages. It seems that there has never been a time in Western societies when the challenges to long-term relationships have been so great. Over many long, fascinating conversations, Kenny helped me see the natural connection between what EFT has to offer and the urgent need of the church to help people of faith shape more positive and lasting relationships. He is passionate about bringing this powerful, effective system for helping couples to people of faith and helping Christians connect with the insights offered by EFT from the vantage point of their own biblical worldview. Our conversations also explored the broadened application of attachment theory to man's relationship with God, the ultimate giver of secure connection and love. Christians believe, as do I, that we are indeed created for connection. The Bible teaches that as creatures made in the very image of God, we bear the likeness of the one who made us in love for love, and who, in and of himself, dwells in a community of love, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. I was touched and inspired by the realization that my work could guide readers back to the unhindered, loving connection that we were created for, and that the Bible refers to again and again. For my part, I shared with Kenny how my obsession with the drama of close relationships came out of my childhood struggles with the everyday mayhem of my parents' marriage. Watching them felt like helplessly seeing a train wreck happen again and again. Still, I knew that my parents loved each other deeply. In my father's last days, he wept raw tears for my mother, although they had been separated for more than 20 years. As an adult, I became obsessed with understanding this mysterious and powerful emotion that defeated my parents, complicated my own life, and seemed to be the central source of both joy and suffering for so many of us. I knew in my heart that there just had to be a path through the maze that could lead us all to more empowering, enduring love. I followed this fascination into a career in counseling and psychology, and in the final phase of my doctorate studies, I started to work with couples. I was instantly mesmerized by the intensity of their struggles and, at the same time, continued to feel completely lost and defeated in the face of these struggles, just as I did when I was a child. So I decided to simply let my couples teach me about the emotional rhythms and patterns in the dance of romantic love. I began to tape my couple sessions and watch them over and over again. Slowly, I began to grasp the key negative and positive emotional moments that defined a relationship and started formulating a clear way of working with couples that was based on changing these moments. My colleagues and I decided to call it Emotionally Focused Therapy, EFT for short. This was a natural choice as it became clearer and clearer that, more than anything else, it was partners' emotional signals that shaped the dance between lovers. Emotions communicate and organize our responses to our loved ones. They are the music of the dance. We discovered that changing the music changed the dance. As we developed EFT, our work was constantly informed and refined by the emerging new science of adult bonding, created by leading developmental and social psychologists. My lab's research studies began to show conclusive evidence that we could indeed help distressed partners transform their relationships. The results of these studies were, and still are, positive, powerful, and convincing. In addition, with the help of bonding science, we began to understand why distressed partners seethed with such strong emotions as they struggled to get a loved one to respond, and how the new conversations we shaped with our couples, we call them hold-me-tight conversations, made a lasting difference to these couples' love relationships. Many years and studies later, it is perfectly clear that romantic love is all about attachment. Emotional bonding is a wired-in survival code designed to keep loved ones close so that they will be there when we are in need. In order to truly thrive, we all need someone to depend on, a loved one who can offer reliable emotional connection and comfort. This partnership is the natural antidote to humanity's greatest pain, being alone in the face of the uncertainty of life. I now have a spiritual perspective on this and can see bonding relationships as echoing what the Bible describes as becoming one with a loved one. Genesis chapter 2 verse 24, Mark chapter 10 verse 8. God responds to the pain of human isolation by giving man an intimate partner who shares his bone and flesh. Genesis chapter 2 verse 23. God actually announces Eve's role in Adam's life using the Hebrew word for helper, Genesis chapter 2 verse 18, which, in scripture thereafter, is most often used in reference to the strength and comfort God Himself provides as He comes alongside humanity in the inevitable but frightening battles of life. The love between adult partners is indeed infinitely more than the way it is all too often described, as a slightly adolescent mix of sexuality and sentiment. In my conversations with Kenny that inspired this book,
we hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.